So my name is Barbara Ryan, and I'm director of the Group on Earth Observations, GEO, Secretariat in Geneva, Switzerland. People both in NASA and the USGS, dating back to 1972 when the first satellite went up, really at that time felt that the data ought to be broadly and openly available. Now, finances were an issue, and so I think that's what started the agency out selling that data. But a number of events happened. Obviously, the internet came into being, and so instead of sending out scenes on physical tapes, all of a sudden you could distribute data over the web. Anyway, number of factors came together, but of course it was a political decision to make the change. What it's changed is it's changed people's views of the planet. We've got to look at the data. We've got to look at how these changes are occurring if we're going to take any appropriate management actions for whatever, land degradation, water use, energy consumption. And so it's changed people's view of how the Earth is changing. The data policy for Landsat was a paradigm shift for the world. There's no doubt about it. Europe has adopted a broad open data policy for their Copernicus program, the Sentinel series, and I'm absolutely convinced that wouldn't have happened if the U.S. was still selling Landsat data. Whether it's environmental governance and transparency or education or capacity building, or I think particularly for this administration, or any administration really, economic growth, broad open data is the only way you're going to get there.